So you've got a whole bunch of data that's living in Snowflake, and you want to get it from Snowflake into Kafka. How do you do that? Well, it turns out sharing data securely across two private systems in a way that ensures only those systems can see it and no other parties is really difficult. Today, I'm going to show you a really quick and easy way to get that working securely. You'll be up and running with a production setup in less than 15 minutes. Before I get into that, let's quickly talk about the alternatives in this space so that you can understand how Ockham is different. All right, so if you want to connect two systems, the options you usually have are one of these. Now, private link or secure connect, depending on which cloud you're on, is a fantastic way to try and connect two systems. It gives you a point-to-point connection between the systems that need to communicate with each other. Unfortunately, for a whole bunch of reasons, that can be difficult, either because you're on the wrong cloud, you're a multi-cloud setup, you're on-prem, or there's just organizationally really difficult to implement a system like Private Link or Secure Connect. So what other options do you have? Well, there is VPC peering. Again, only works if you're on the same cloud as the systems you want to connect. Things like VPNs, but both of these suffer from the problem that you're ultimately trying to take two networks and make them look like one. You're opening up very big doors into these systems, into these networks, and then trying to close them down again to make sure that the two things that need to talk are the only things that can talk to each other. Any changes to those networks continue to add new risk, and you need to ensure that the rules are in place still match the intentions that were originally set. Now, for good reason, neither of those options is available for you as a Snowflake customer. What else do we have? Well, making things addressable on the public internet so that you can reach them. We know that's not a good idea. That's why Private Link exists, to prevent us from doing that. And in a Kafka situation, a lot of security-focused Kafka vendors will just not let you expose your broker to the public internet. And then there's the mess of trying to maintain IP allow lists, which is still putting things on the public internet. It takes a big door and tries to close it back down again to something much smaller, something that meets the original intention. Ockham's different. Ockham allows you to create point-to-point connections, much like Private Link, but with the added benefit that it runs anywhere, across any network, any topology, any transport. That means you can be on any cloud, you can be multi-cloud, you can be hybrid, you can be running on-prem, you can use the same solution everywhere. What's more, the Ockham protocol automatically takes care of a whole bunch of things that provide even greater security for your point-to-point connection. Whether that's the way we handle enrollment tickets to authenticate nodes into your Ockham projects, the way that those nodes are mutually authenticated so that only intended participants are able to register with those projects, the policy-based access controls you can apply on top of that to further restrict what nodes are able to communicate with each other, or the automatic key rotation, which ensures you're always reducing the risk in your systems. Ockham is the most secure way to connect two private systems, no matter where they are. And today, I'm going to show you how in less than 15 minutes, you can connect your Snowflake warehouse to your Kafka cluster, no matter where it's running. But we're going to use Amazon MSK in this example. To install the connector, go to the Snowflake Marketplace and search for Ockham Push to Kafka. You'll see the Marketplace page like this. Click the Get button. Choose your warehouse. Click the Get button to continue. This will start the installation process within that warehouse. And now that it's complete, we can configure it. A connector requires certain privileges to operate. Click the Grant button to grant those automatically, and then click Activate. Now we can launch the app and walk through the configuration screens. It'll take a few moments for the warehouse to start up the app. Okay, now that it's loaded, you'll get a bit of a description of what's required and the steps we need to go through. We're just going to run through it very quickly though. So click Next, we're presented with this screen. And it's asking us to provide an Ockham enrollment ticket. This ticket is what allows the node that runs within the Snowflake container to register with our Ockham project, and then we can use that to connect other nodes to it later. Now in this next step, I'm going to show you how to sign up for Ockham and set yourself up as an administrator to your Ockham project. If you've already got an account and you've done that before though, you can skip that and go straight to setting up the MSK node. You'll need an Ockham account to get started. So go to ockham.io, sign up, and it will give you instructions on how to download Ockham command. You'll see here we're running the install command, it's installing Ockham, and we'll use that to generate the tickets that will connect our services. So here we are, Ockham has been installed. We're going to enroll our local machine as an administrator, and that will allow us to generate the tickets we require. So we'll just, we've copied the code to the clipboard, continue, we'll confirm the details, and we're all set. If we switch back to the terminal, you'll see that it's signed in and it has activated my local machine. Okay, it's found a project. If you don't have a project already, we'll set one up for you automatically. To complete this demo, you're going to need access to an Apache Kafka compatible cluster. Hopefully you have one already that you can use for this. I already do. I'm using Amazon MSK. If you don't though, just click the Create Cluster button on the MSK screen and accept the default. It's very quick and easy to get it set up. This is the cluster we're going to use for the rest of this example. Okay, so you're running an Apache Kafka cluster. What I'm going to show you now is how to run an Ockham node that's going to serve as one end of our point-to-point connection. We're going to set up the node next to the Kafka cluster. To install the Ockham node for Amazon MSK, go to the AWS Marketplace and search for Ockham Amazon MSK. You'll find this listing here. Click the Continue to Subscribe button. And then continue to the configuration. You can confirm the details and then continue to launch. And we click the Launch button. This will take us through the cloud formation flow where we're filling the details about our specific environment. So accept the defaults on this screen. This is what tells it the template to use that we've designed to manage the service for you. Give the stack a name. And then choose the VPC where your Kafka brokers are running, your MSK broker. I can see that the VPC I need is not here. I've chosen the wrong region. So we'll switch to the region where my MSK is running. We'll go through this flow again. Give it a quick name. And yeah, the VPC we need now in the dropdown. And then choose a subnet that has a broker available within that subnet. You'll be able to see these details from the client configuration information. Specify an instance type. 8x large is probably more than I need, so I'm going to drop this down to just a large. You can run any instance type you like here. Just specify whatever family and instance size meets your requirements. And now we need an enrollment ticket. This is what's used to allow our node to register with our Ockham project. So we're going to create a ticket here, give it a usage count of 1 so that it will expire in 24 hours. So the ticket must be redeemed within 24 hours. And we're going to put an attribute of Kafka on this. And also have a shorthand permission here to say we're going to allow it to create a relay called Kafka. The output of this command is going to go to a file we're calling kafka.ticket. Once that completes, I'm going to copy the contents of that file to my clipboard. I'm going to paste it into here. Now we need to specify the bootstrap servers with the ports. So we'll paste those in again from the client configuration file. And then the JSON node configuration. This will be passed to the Ockham command as it starts up to let it know what services it should be speaking to. If you go to our documentation for this particular use case, it'll have a standard one that you can use there. Or you can copy what you see here. We're going to accept all the defaults on this screen. And again, this is just confirming all the details we've already supplied. I'm fine with everything that's been done. I accept the capabilities and we hit submit. Okay, our stack creation is in progress and that should complete in a few minutes. When that's done, we'll now have an Ockham node running that will be able to be used as a relay to communicate with our MSK brokers. That's one half of our connection done already. Now we're going to set up the Snowflake side of things and run a node within Snowflake Container Services. Now we need to generate a ticket for Snowflake. This is going to allow the node that's running in a container within Snowflake to register with our Ockham project. So here We create a ticket. We say this ticket is only allowed to be redeemed once. It has a usage count of one. It needs to be redeemed within 2 hours. And we're going to apply an attribute named Snowflake to any node that enrolls with this ticket. And the output of this command, we're going to save into a file called snowflake.ticket. We'll then copy the contents of that file to the clipboard and we'll paste it into the configuration screen. Move next. So that I can show you how a stream works, I'm going to first show you how to set up a stream. So as an example, I'm going to connect to our warehouse and our test database here, and I'm going to create a table called customers. It's pretty simple. It's just got an ID, a name, and an email. And then I'm going to create a stream on that table. So the stream will be called customer stream and it will be on table customers. So we'll run this command. We'll create these two resources. Okay, and we're done. And so now we can finish the mapping information on our configuration screen. We're going to enter the name of the Snowflake stream. So this is Kafka Test Warehouse, our public schema, and customer stream was the stream that we created. And then we're going to give it a name of the topic to send that to in Kafka. If that topic doesn't exist, we'll create one automatically. So hit the plus, adds it into the configuration detail. We're going to accept the defaults for everything else. Click next. And now we need to grant some privileges to the various things in this system. So first we're going to create a stored procedure to make granting privileges easier in the future. So we quickly run this. Then we copy the other commands that are on that page, we run them, that will use the stored procedure to grant permissions to our app that the app needs to work. Run that, it verifies that all these permissions have been added. Oh, and I forgot the top of the box. So we grant access to the egress. This allows our node to speak out to Ockam Orchestrator and to our project to establish the point-to-point route required for this to talk to our MSK broker. We click next. And our container is starting. This will take 10 or 15 minutes. I'll skip ahead here though in the video so you don't have to wait for that. And here it is, it's done. When it's finished starting up, you'll get confirmation that the application is running, the Ockam portal is running successfully, and the producer that is pushing data to Kafka is also running successfully and able to use the portal. Okay, all that's left now is to test it and show that it works. Now I have a Docker container that I can run with the Kafka tools that is able to talk to my MSK broker. So I'll spin that up and I'll run the Kafka consumer and listen to the customer's topic so that we can see any data that comes through. Now I'm going to switch into Snowflake and I'm going to insert a row into that customer's table. Now remember there's a stream on this customer's table, so any data I enter here will automatically be published into my stream as well. So just insert a new row here. Give an ID of one, Alice and Alice at Ockham. We'll run that. Okay, that's completed successfully. We'll switch over to our consumer and we should see within a moment, here it is. This is the change data capture record that's been sent to our Kafka topic. Let's put another one in. Let's make this Bob. And we'll run that, switch over, you should see within a second or two. Bob, we'll get an insert record. There we go. And to show you what happens with other commands, let's delete everything in the customers table. Run that, and then over in our topic in a moment. Oh, sorry, run, there we go. And over in our topic, we'll see two delete actions. There we go. One, two. As promised, in less than 15 minutes, I've shown you how to publish changes to a table in Snowflake to a Snowflake stream, have the stream push those changes to a Kafka topic in a private Kafka cluster over a point-to-point connection that is encrypted with automatic key rotation. You haven't had to change anything inside a network, allow any ingress rules, IP allow list, no network level changes. This is something that is super quick and easy to set up and almost impossible to get wrong. If you haven't been following along with me during this demo, what are you waiting for? Give it a shot. We'd love to hear your feedback.